The Iranian embassy in Manila vows to assist the Philippine government in securing the release of 18 Filipino sailors on board an American oil tanker seized by Iran. Foreign Affairs Undersecretary for Migrant Workers Affairs Eduardo De Vega says the Philippine envoy in Tehran is reaching out to local authorities. De Vega adds there is no indication Filipinos are being mistreated.
Ang alam namin so far, usually, based on previous experience, whenever this happens, they don't harm the Filipino crewmen. No? Wala silang sinasaktan. Mm-hmm. So we cannot confirm at ano yung condition sila kasi hinihintay namin yung official report ng ating embahada sa Tehran na who is checking this with the local authorities and of course asking for the release.
De Vega also says the Filipinos are not considered hostages. Meanwhile, the United States calls on Iran to immediately release the ship and its crew. The U.S. describes the incident an unlawful seizure of a commercial vessel aimed at disrupting international commerce. According to the Iranian state media, Tehran has seized the tanker in retaliation for the theft of Iranian oil by the U.S. last year. Philippine government has extended financial aid to overseas Filipino workers who lost their jobs in New Zealand following the sudden closure of their company. According to the Department of Migrant Workers, 107 Filipino workers have received 1,050 New Zealand dollars, or about 36,000 pesos. DMW Undersecretary for Policy and International Cooperation Patricia Yvonne Kaunan says over 400 other affected employees will also receive the same assistance.
Ang Department of Migrant Workers po ay sa pagtutulungan with the Department of Foreign Affairs ay nagpaabot na ng tulong sa unang batch po ng mga apektadong OFWs. Nagpadala po tayo ng financial assistance po dyan sa kanila. And we are expecting po mga around 340 ang makakatanggap po nitong financial assistance.
Kaunan also says several employers have expressed willingness to recruit the displaced Filipino workers. The U.S. Commerce Secretary is visiting Manila this March for an American trade mission to the Philippines. The White House said Friday, Secretary Gina Raimondo will lead the delegation for the two-day trip starting March 11. The undertaking will seek to enhance U.S. companies' contributions to critical sectors in the Philippines. It is also seen to reinforce Manila's role as a key hub for regional supply chains and high-quality investment. Aside from that, the White House says the visit will help advance Manila's transition to clean energy and improve food security in the country. The trade mission was pledged by U.S. President Joe Biden to Philippine President Ferdinand Marcos Jr. in the latter's official visit to America in April. Leaders of the two nations then agreed to boost economic cooperation between the two longtime allies. China once again accuses the Philippines of using external forces to stir up maritime tensions. Beijing's defense ministry says Manila's joint activities with foreign allies only escalate tensions and undermine peace and stability in the region. It warns it will take necessary measures to safeguard China's maritime rights and interests.
The Philippines' attempt to court countries outside the region by carrying out so-called joint patrols is just to use external forces to stir up troubles in the South China Sea. We urge the Philippines to abandon speculative and adventurous mindset and stop irresponsible exaggeration and hype. Chinese troops will stay on high alert and continue to take all necessary measures to resolutely safeguard national sovereignty, maritime rights, and interests.
Beijing's remark came a week after Manila and Washington launched their first joint patrols in the West Philippine Sea for 2024. More than 1.2 billion baht worth of assets have been seized from a major online scamming gang in Thailand. The confiscated properties include more than 70 cars, 10 million baht worth of foreign currencies, and dozens of land title deeds. The law enforcement operation also led to the arrest of three suspects, including the alleged ringleader in several raids on 13 locations. The cyber police say the gang deceived its victims by posing as state officials and demanding money transfers into their mule accounts in exchange for having charges against them dropped. Other times, they would lure their victims to invest in foreign exchange or fake online businesses. A group of travel agencies says there's a stronger Philippine passport now could attract more tourists and investments into the country. Marigel Manotok, president of the Philippine Travel Agencies Association, tells Teleradio Serbisyo the country's ranking of 73 in the Henley Passport Index is its best since 2014. She believes the Philippine passports can be stronger if the government strengthens diplomatic ties with other countries. The Henley Passport Index is based on the number of destinations a traveler can visit visa-free. Now, Filipinos can currently travel to 66 destinations without a visa.
I think there has to be collaboration between government agencies and private sectors and civil society. Kasi we need to, I guess, continuously promote our Philippine passport as well. By strengthening ho nga yung mga diplomatic ties at saka international relations can influence influential bilateral agreements. I think we're on the road naman ho. So I think with all the new investment, they can demonstrate the Philippines' economic stability. Okay. So hopefully ho, sa tingin ko baka umakyat na ho yung ranking natin next year.
The Israeli embassy sharing innovative farming methods to agriculture students in Tarlac. Meanwhile, an urban garden in Taguig is hoping to inspire more people to cultivate their own farming spaces. Jervis Manahan gives us a look.
The Israeli embassy partnered with Tarlac Agricultural University to introduce modern farming methods to students and farmers alike. They built greenhouses equipped with cutting-edge technology such as Bluetooth-operated misting systems and automated sprinklers.
We have a lot of technologies and practices that we want to share with the Philippines. We partnered with the university with the idea that the knowledge and the practices have to be shared also with the practitioners, with the farmers.
The university says opportunities for technology transfer will be greatly beneficial to their community.
Nagkakaroon po kasi sila ng hands-on experience kagaya ng mga trainings na nangyari this past few days. Gamit yung greenhouse, so mamimitigate po niya yung climate change. So yung mga crops natin, mas mataas or mas madami yung production na magagawa.
The embassy hopes to replicate the same design to other universities in the country. Meanwhile, at the heart of Commercial District Bonifacio Global City lies an urban farm, the BGC Community Garden. The garden, occupying a lot of 1,500 square meters, produces several kinds of vegetables. It is the pandemic project of entrepreneur Louis Gutierrez, whose business closed down at the height of nationwide lockdowns.
One day, naglalakad ako dun sa aming street. May nakita akong isang empty space, empty lot. Bigla ako naisip, sabi ko, baka pwede magtanim. And so that I can give jobs to my employees. So biglang pumayag yung owner. We started doing online training with this agriculturist, si Erwin. And then later on, nung nag-open na konti, tinuruan na kami with my team from my company to do farming. So nakapag-harvest kami after a few months, inimbitahan ko yung mga residente nung village. And then yung mga unang produce namin, binigay namin sa makasambahay, mga security guards, and you know, it became a community, puntahan ng community.
Aside from being a constant source of fresh vegetables, the farm also provides employment to people who lost their jobs during the pandemic. The farm's manager used to be an office worker.
Wala na ako ng work nung pandemic time, but because of urban farmers, nakapag-provide po ako sa family ko kasi nabigyan po nila ako ng trabaho. Before, zero knowledge po ako, but because of Sir Louis po, pinasok niyo po ako sa iba't ibang mga trainings, mga ibang workshop para naturuan naman po kami. And then now, kami naman po yung nag-share ng knowledge namin.
At least one lady guard discovered her passion for growing vegetables when the garden expanded.
happy place po talaga dito, sir. Iba po yung ano dito to serve. Na halimbawa po, makakaprovide kami pala ng fresh veggies in Orban. Napakasaya po na nakikita po namin yung mga walk-ins at dito po yung mga customers namin na ay makakatikim pala kami ng fresh veggies at natural.
They are now hoping to inspire more children and youth to try urban farming and help our nation's food security. Jervis Manahan, ABS-CBN News.